Hey everyone, we're jumping right into week two of Psalms in Solitude, where we work through the Psalms 5 days a week. We've got a good one here for a Monday morning in Psalm 6. Psalm 6 is the first of seven penitential psalms spread out throughout the Psalter. Penitential meaning just prayers of repentance. Many people are familiar with Psalm 51, where David is repentant over his sin with Bathsheba, and so there are six others, the first of which being Psalm 6. And there's so much we can learn from the penitential psalm. So let's read Psalm 6 together today. It says, Lord, do not rebuke me in your anger. Do not discipline me in your wrath. Be gracious to me, Lord, for I am weak. Heal me, Lord, for my bones are shaking. My whole being is shaken with terror. And you, Lord, how long? Turn, Lord, rescue me. Save me because of your faithful love, for there is no remembrance of you in death. Who can thank you in Sheol? I'm weary from my groaning. With my tears I dampen my bed and drench my couch every night. My eyes are swollen from grief. They grow old because of all my enemies. Depart from me, all evildoers, for the Lord has heard the sound of my weeping. The Lord has heard my plea for help. The Lord accepts my prayer. All my enemies will be ashamed and shake with terror. They will turn back and suddenly be disgraced. Now, obviously, this isn't an enjoyable psalm to read. Many of the psalms are not enjoyable. However, we need to be careful not to just write it off as useless just because it's not fun to read, just because it's difficult content. The reality is, the penitential psalms, Psalm 6 specifically, there's so much that we can learn about a right relationship with God because they teach us what to do when we get out of step with the Lord and with his word. So there's been debate about Psalm 6, just being honest with you guys, about whether this is actually a penitential psalm or whether it's merely a psalm of grief. I think we see both elements here. If you'll look at verses 1 through 5, very much seems like a prayer of repentance to the Lord from David. But then the second half, which is, I think, where the debate comes from, we do see very strongly just David's great grief. And I think if we take the psalm on the whole and we put these two halves together, I think what we see is David is grieving. He's grieving over his sin, and he's grieving over the reality that sin has birthed in his own life. That is causing him to grieve. And isn't that how it should be for us on this side of the cross? For those of us who love the Lord and who live under the covenant of grace, where our sins have been paid for by Christ's death on the cross, sin should grieve us. We should recognize the great cost that Christ paid for our sin. And it should hurt our hearts when we recognize that we have sinned against the Lord and we have rebelled against him and his way. We don't talk about ongoing repentance often in churches today. When we talk about repentance, it's usually that initial act of turning from our sin to follow the Lord. But we need to talk about ongoing repentance in the Christian life. So I want to encourage you guys to do something here with Psalm 6. Take some time, as we finish this video, take some time and just ponder the sin in your own life, whatever that is. Maybe you have some secret sin that you've been keeping. Maybe you just have an attitude issue. Maybe you've been living selfishly. Maybe you've been living incredibly prideful. Whatever it is for you, think about that. Ponder that sin for a moment. And then I want to ask you, pray Psalm 6 to the Lord in light and thinking specifically about your own sin. Pray Psalm 6 to the Lord. Allow your own sin to grieve you as it grieved David, because you have turned away from the God who has saved you in your sin. When you've done that, trust in the Lord the same way that David trusts the Lord in verse 9, where he says, the Lord has heard my plea for help. The Lord accepts my prayer. Pray to him and trust that he has heard you. Pray and trust that he has forgiven your sin. And then strive to honor him with your next steps. The, Christian life should be marked by ongoing repentance. We should be known by that. Hebrews 12 talks about the discipline that the Lord has for his children. And it ends with verse 11 like this. It says, "No discipline seems enjoyable at the time, but painful. Later on, however, it yields the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it." This happens, this discipline and this righteous fruit that comes from it happens through the repentance, ongoing repentance in our lives. So may our lives be marked in the same way that we see in Psalm 6, that we see in Hebrews 12, where we recognize the good discipline of our Father and seek to live righteous in his sight. God bless you guys. We hope to see you tomorrow for Psalm 7.